exhausted, overworked, and take another pill. Or to keep the owner of the corporation stacking billions. These corporations manipulating.
All right, straight ahead, we'll get to this lightweight bout between Tony Ferguson and New Jersey's Jim Miller.
You ready? You ready?
All right, so here we go. The weight and the height gives way to the action right here on one side. Maybe the division's most well-rounded fighter, taking on arguably the biggest submission threat in this division.
Because he's such a great submission grappler, I believe that this is the most dangerous fight for him in the division.
Wow.
He needs to maintain his space, stay away from this guy at all costs, and force him to stand up for him.
All right, here we go. First round is underway. No denying the big reach advantage for him tonight. We'll see if he can get that jab going early.
Look for him to surf on the outside. Use that long jab to keep his distance and only engage on his terms.
Nice punch by Tony Ferguson.
Caught that kick there.
Much improved defensively as he blocks the shot. Ooh.
Now we're just thrown to end the fight.
Yep. DC, didn't take him long to find his range here tonight, huh?
His timing is on point.
Double leg.
Oh, that was a big takedown. Is this the one that's gonna break him? Oh, nice headlock.
Gets caught with that punch. Not the easiest guy in the world to hit, but he got caught there. Punch coming, it's blocked. Right hand upstairs.
Yeah, he's mixed it all up.
Well, a lot of people think he might have the best jab in this division, certainly using it effectively here.
I mean, one of the best jabs in the world across all combat sports. The way that it just comes out, it's...
Oh, would you look at this, an Ominari roll. Right into a heel hook. You don't see that every day. It's flashy, it's unorthodox, but proving to be effective here. Let's see if he can finish the fight.
Now he's okay. Now he can escape.
And he caught the kick. We'll see what he can do with it. Oh, he got that inside leg kick to the target there, DC. You don't want to eat too many of those.
No, you can't. It starts to beat up the inside thigh. That is a technique you use to really slow down your opponent.
Right punch has been the money weapon for him tonight, and he landed it again there.
If his opponent does not change something, he will continue to throw the strike until he makes it stop throwing. Nice punch, man.
Man, he's timing his shots nicely. It's like Tom Brady out there. He hasn't missed the target.
I mean, you insist on bringing in Tom Brady. Stop it. John, stop.
Round two is next. All right, there's the horn indicating the end of the round. So potentially a big factor here, ladies and gentlemen. The cut on the cheek sustained in that round. Certainly better to be below than above the eye, but the cut man's got to get in there and close that thing up. All right, let's take a look back at some of the replays from that last round.
Unbelievable to see these high-level competitors get in each other's face, tuck their chin, bite down on the mouth guard, and just let it all hang out over the course of 5 minutes.
All right, round two. Punch is blocked.
Big punch man over the top. I'll be gonna follow this one.
Well, he continues to stay busy and he continues to land with volume punches here.
I mean, volume, but he's not wasting anything. He's so accurate out there.
Miller's tough as it gets, but how about the size of that bruise starting to form on his right side?
He's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Oh, nice land there with the punch. You see, he's taking advantage of what is an obvious edge in reach. And he connects with a punch there. We'll see if there's more where that came from.
Boxing, boxing, boxing.
Oh, nice offering there by Tony Ferguson. We'll see if he can follow it up here, champ.
I mean, he usually does. He does not let guys off the hook. Tony Ferguson is a guy that has a killer's mindset. When he gets you hurt, he's looking to finish.
All right, so he connects with another punch there. His head still attached to his body.
The last time I saw an uppercut like that, it was Overeem versus Ngannou. And you know they still haven't found Alex Overeem's head.
Timing his shots nicely here, champ.
He's doing a great job of mixing everything up and using a lot of reverse strikes. Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him.
Well, that'll quiet the storm. Shot blocked by Miller. Man, as he landed a high volume of strikes here in round two, definitely picking up the pace after round one. So he got the message from the...
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his head covered very bad.
Just missed with the left there. Oh, he tagged him with the punch there, DC. That's an educated left hand.
He's got great timing with his left hand. Hip over when he throws that kick.
Hard shots landing on both sides here. Oh! Huge right hand!
Now look at him jumping in to try to get the finish. Oh, he got it back!
Less than a minute to go in the round. Quick hip movement there, and he does indeed get back to his feet. Nicely done. Oh, he lands another strike to the body, really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection, and these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds. He comes forward. Whoa!
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish this fight.
Left-right combo is good.
Boom!
What a round. Oh, the round is over and blood is just fauceting out of his cheek. That cheek has gotten out of control. Cutman can only do so much, and given the fact that that cut continues to be attacked by the opponent, if this thing gets any worse, they're gonna stop this fight. Well, he had a lot more than a puncher's chance coming in. Big knock.
Deep breath. All right, listen.
Are you ready? Ready?
Third round underway.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Yes, but he hurt him in the last round. Same exact one.
All right, so a nice move. I'm not sure his opponent knows where
he is. No, he is on Beach Street right now. He's seeing Creech Bird over the top of his head. When you take a hook like that, you are on wobbly legs.
Punch by Miller.
Real nice body kick in.
All right, so another one. Well, he works hard to get up again here, but he looks hooked. All right, he engages in the single collar tie.
He landed it perfectly. Perfect place. Perfect position.
Winner here was so aggressive with his onslaught. He wanted to make sure he kept the judges out of the equation. Mission accomplished on that front as he gets the TKO victory here tonight. So a seminal moment for him here tonight as he gets the win by TKO. That is one they'll be talking about for quite some time.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Ian Levine's called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 28 seconds of round number three. Declaring the winner by TKO, Jim Miller.
Well, the celebration is on over there in the corner, and nothing subdued about it. They put a lot of time into this training camp and into this performance, and certainly their athlete delivered.
It was a result that they desired. They said, I don't care how this match ends, as long as I'm not standing there waiting on the judges. He got his opponent hurt, and he found the follow-up shots that allowed him to get the TKO.
I'm on top of the world. I'm on top of the world.